Good day, friends. It is me, HLModTech, and a user just asked me, how do you place objects exactly where you want when you're looking to 3D print them? Friends, I've got some steps for you, so let's get cracking. All right, everybody, so of course, start with create new design, and then you need to decide whether you're going to design in millimeters or inches. I prefer millimeters, but if you are doing something with inches, it is smart to just switch to that really quick. You may also have to change the size of your grid just so you can see how this works. I'm going to type 300 and I'm going to type 300 so that my grid is a new size, pretending that my project needed this. And then just hit update grid. So now we've got more room to play with. So I am going to bring out a shape, and now I'm going to type the dimensions of what I'm building. So I'm pretending mine is 150 by 200. I'm going to pretend that it is a piece of material that is 3 millimeters thick. All right, friends, before I go any further, I'm going to name this so I can get back to it later. I'm going to call it wall plate. Mine's make-believe, but obviously the user I was chatting with, theirs is real. So we want to place things exactly where we want. All right, friends, let's bring out a cylinder. And one of my favorite tricks is to stretch and then type the number I want. So say I want size 4. Notice when the ruler's on, it breaks that. So I actually have to type 4 in both boxes. That is an interesting thing that I just learned. Now I want to place this inside this shape. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to say use the endpoint because I want to change it. And I want it to be inside this way. And I'm going to type the number I want it to be. I'm going to say negative 10. Notice that way it's going to the end of it. If I wanted to be exactly 10, then I would type negative 14 because it's using that endpoint. Same thing here, instead of 20, I'm going to change it to 14 and press enter. And I have just moved that shape 10 in on both sides. I want to put another one over here. So I'm just going to bring my ruler to this corner. Once again, I want to zoom in. Check out this trick for zooming in. If I put a small shape there and do F for fit view, that gets me to the spot, and then I can delete that temporarily while I align my ruler right to the edge of my shape. So now that I've got that lined up, let's bring out our shape. This time I'm going to do my shift stretch again just because I still can't believe it doesn't work. I'm going to do size 15. Notice I still have to type the 15 again and again. So let's find that piece and do the 15 and press enter. Now it does like a circle. I do want to make it totally round just because that's cool. And then I'm going to choose my endpoint again. Remember, you can just click to switch those. And once again, this time I'm going to go negative 20. And then on this side, I'm going to do positive 20. Now notice that changed the measurement, so I'm going to undo it. And then I want to click on this one. So that was the shape, this is the distance. Type my 20 and press enter, and we have just accurately placed those two pieces exactly where we want. Now just because I want to show you this, I'm going to click on the first, click on the second, and I'm going to do control D, which means duplicate. And if we hit mirror and choose this one right here, boom, you will have accurately placed all four corners in one crazy step. Once you select them all and do control G or hit the group button, you will have your project with your holes accurately cut. Remember, friends, when you're ready to get rid of your ruler, you just simply hit dismiss, and boom, the ruler is gone until you choose to bring it back again. Friends, I hope you found this totally useful, and if you did, please give it a like. If you got a question, comment, or a suggestion, add it down below. If you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Smash that subscribe button, and last but not least, hit that notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new video from me, HLModTech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.